Hi, my name is Bintu Harwani, and in this Android lecture, we will learn how to create two radio button groups. Basically, one radio group has several radio buttons, and the user can select only one radio button out of that group. For example, in your app, you want to display two set of options. Like in a shopping cart, you want the user to select how the person wants to pay, through Visa card, through UPI, through cash on delivery, whatever. So you want the user to select one of them. And in another set of options, you want the user to select how he wants the delivery, whether he wants a fast delivery or he wants a free delivery. So to display two set of options out of which the user can select only one out of every group, you need more than one radio button groups. So let us see how several radio button groups can be created in an app. Let's start.
So in this Android app, we learn how to create two radio groups. In the previous fifth lecture, we have already seen how to use a radio group. Recall that a radio group is a container which contains several radio buttons, and those radio buttons are selected mutually exclusively. That means only one radio button can be selected in a radio group. So in this lecture, we will be creating two radio groups. In this lecture, the app that we will be making will be having this output. It will ask for the payment method. As we've done in the last lecture, fifth lecture, please do watch that fifth lecture and then watch this video. You will find it very easy to understand. And this is another radio group showing the type of delivery the user wants, whether it is a free delivery or it's a chargeable fast delivery. And whatsoever the method or delivery the user chosen, and this text view will display the chosen methods out of the two, right? So let's start with it. First of all, launch the Android Studio. This is the app that we've already seen. This is the app that we created in the fifth lecture. We'll continue with that only, right? We have to add one more radio group, right? So what we'll do that we'll go into the buttons and make it a bit bigger for you. And this radio group, I'll just click and drag it over here. This text view, which was supposed to display the output, I'll drag it to the bottom. This is radio group that I have dragged and dropped. This radio group will contain two radio buttons to represent free delivery and the chargeable fast delivery. So just click this radio button from here and drop it on this radio group. One more. Right. Select this radio group, set its name, radio group delivery, right? This radio group does not have any constant. See, this is the constant layout, and these plus four signs is indicating that neither this radio group has top constant, left, bottom or right constant. So I'll do what? I'll click this node and drop it over here. It is asking, you want to establish the constant with the upper group, but you want to establish the constant with its top border or with the bottom border. I'll go with the bottom border. Gap which is showing 42 SIP. I'll make it 40. Alright, to make this radio group to appear at the center of the screen, I'll click this node and drag it to the left border of the layout. And we'll also drag this right node to the right edge of the layout. So it will appear at the center of the layout width. These two radio buttons, I need to increase the gapping, the padding of these radio buttons inside this radio group. So I'll click with shift click, I'll select these radio buttons. I'll go to the layout margin. See, these are the layout margin, right? So I'll make the 20 SP as the layout margin top. Left margin as 20 SP. Can you see the padding over here? See, right also 20 SP. And then I select this radio button and the bottom layout margin of this, I'll make it 20 SP. Right. Also, I'll select these radio buttons from here. With the shift click, I'll select both the radio buttons and I'll increase its size the text size to, from 14 SP, I'll make it 30 SP to make them visible. And the ID of this radio button, I'll make it free delivery. And the text of it, I'll make it fast delivery. Free delivery. Similarly, the ID of this radio button, I'll make it fast delivery. And here, the text, I'll make it chargeable fast delivery. This is, I'll make the text of it, right? And the bottom text view is here. The constant of this bottom text view is still attached to this radio group. I'll just see here, I'll click on this cross here to delete this top constant, and I'll click and drop it over here, and I'll attach the top constant of this text view with the bottom border of the radio group, the lower radio group, and I'll set its spacing to 40 pixels. Let's see what is the spacing of this. Is bit high. How much is the spacing of this? 60. I'll make it 40. 40. This is how much? 40. And this is 40. Okay. One thing more. I'll just change the ID of this text view to text view response. Because in the code that I am going to use is text view response. I'll show you the. It is asking whether shall I make the changes everywhere, wherever this text view is used. I have asked it to do it. Yes. This is my code. First, understand the code. To display the radio buttons which are selected from both the radio groups, I have defined two string variables. One is selected pay mode. In Kotlin, you can define a string variable by writing var variable name colon string. Or what you can do is that you assign some string to it. From the assignment, the Kotlin will understand that this is a string variable. Where means variable. You can change this string content anytime you want. If you write well, then it will become a constant. You can't change the content of that string variable. But we have to make it, we have to change it as per the selection done by the user. This string is initialized to the string you have chosen. Plus, this is the string concatenation symbol. Radio button card dot text. The text of radio button card is pay by card. So this selected pay mode string will be assigned. You have chosen pay by card. And this is another string. And it will be assigned the text of the radio button free delivery. The radio button free delivery has a text free delivery written to it. So the text free delivery will be assigned to the selected delivery. Text view response. This is the text view at the bottom, which will display what are the modes being selected, what are the options being selected from both radio groups. So it is set to selected pay mode, that is you have chosen pay by card, and this and is also concatenated in between, and the free delivery. One thing more. See, I have made this radio button selected by default. This radio button also I'll make it selected by default. I'll enhance it. I'll go to the clicked property of this button, checked property, and here at minus sign, the moment I click it, it will become true. So this will be selected by default. Let's go to the code again. See, this is the code. See what you are doing here. This is the bottom text view, and here it will be displayed. You have chosen pay by card and the free delivery, because free delivery is the by default selected radio button, right? This is the radio group that we understood in the last lecture, in the fifth lecture. I recommend please view that fifth lecture of radio buttons. Here what I'm doing, that if the checked ID is radio button card, this is string. This is not a text view. The string is initialized to you have chosen and the content and the text of the radio button, that is pay by card. If the checked ID is radio button net banking, that is if the net banking radio button is selected, this selected pay mode string is initialized what? You have chosen and the text of the radio button net banking. The text of radio button net banking is net banking only. So the selected pay mode will be assigned you have chosen net banking. Similarly, the selected pay mode will be assigned you have chosen cash on delivery. But these are the strings assigned to selected pay mode only. Through this line, the text view will be assigned that string. The text view is assigned the text by this set text method, selected pay mode and selected delivery. Up till now, the selected delivery is the free delivery. This is the second group, and if any of the radio buttons changes its state in this radio group, this method will be executed. Here what you are checking that if the checked ID, if any of the radio button selected is, if it is radio button free delivery, this is the string. This selected delivery string will be assigned the text of radio button free delivery. The text of radio button free delivery is free delivery. Similarly, if the radio button which is checked matches with the radio button fast delivery, radio button fast delivery dot text means the text of the radio button fast delivery will be assigned to the selected delivery string. Shortly, only the selected delivery will be assigned the string, whether it is free delivery or the chargeable fast delivery. And from this line, basically the text view will display the selected mode and the delivery method. So let's copy this code. Don't worry about the code, I'll supply you the link of the code in the description box. Just understand the logic. Here, I'll delete and paste it. This is saying that I'm not able to understand radio group pay mode. So the name of the radio group pay mode, what is the name of this radio group pay mode? M is capital M. So I'll make it M capital here, that's it. Now it should run. Let's run this. The gap is very high. Let's reduce the gap. The gap is very high. What is the gap of this? Gap is 40, make it 30. And the gap of this between this is 40, make it 30 again. And this text view is 40, make it 30, so that the text view is completely visible. Stop it and again run it. Pay by card and free delivery are automatically selected by default. We've checked them by default. You've chosen pay by delivery and free delivery. Let's click on net banking. You've chosen net banking and free delivery. Delivery has gone at the bottom. Cash on. So let's reduce this gap again. Reduce this gap also. This is 24, make it 10. This gap, make it 20. And this gap, make it 20. I think it's okay. Stop and play again. Run it again, and here you'll get the output. See, this is, you have chosen pay by delivery and free delivery, the output, because these are the two radio buttons from both radio groups selected by default. The moment you select net banking, see, you have chosen net banking and free delivery. Change it to charges, chargeable fast delivery. You have chosen net banking and chargeable fast delivery. Select cash on delivery. You have chosen cash on delivery and chargeable fast delivery. See, you have chosen cash on delivery and free delivery. So all the options are working perfectly well. I'll provide you the link for the code used in this app. If you understood the lecture, please subscribe my channel. Share the video with your friends. Do write your comments. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.